Yes, good morning, children. Good morning. How are you all? Fine. Okay, so children, today we are going to start a new topic, that is add and subtract like fractions. So before starting, who can give me the answer? What is like fraction? Like fraction? Yes, Devananda. Like fraction.
Fractions that have same denominators are called like fraction.
Very good. Fractions with same denominator are called like fractions. And what is unlike fraction, Ann Pavida? Unlike fraction.
Unlike fraction that have different denominators are called unlike fractions.
Okay, so unlike fraction means different denominator. So what is unit fraction, Navaneet? Fractions with numerator is equal to 1. Such fractions are unit fraction. And children, how we will compare? How we know if the like fractions, which fraction is greater, which fraction is less? We know like fraction means the denominators are same. So how we know whether they are...
Ma'am, we have to check the numerator.
Very good. We have to check the numerator. And which numerator is greater, that fraction is greater. And which numerator is small number, that fraction is less. Okay, now children, to add and subtract like fractions, we have to add or subtract only their numerators. And the denominators, no change. Okay, denominator will we have to write the same. Okay, now I will show you one video. All the children, please stand on your camera. Aditya, Lynn, Ayman, Mohammed Fadil, all of you. Jomadia, please mute your device. Jomadia, mute your device. And I'm going to show you video. All of you, please. Understand? Did you understand how to add and subtract? What we have to do? No need any explanation. Yes, only the numerator we will add or subtract. And what will be the denominator, whether we have to add denominator? No, we have to just write the same denominator. Okay, so all of you please take your rough book. I will give you one question. Let me see how many were listening properly in the video. Yes? Ma'am, please take rough book faster, children. Rough book. Okay, so if I want to add 4 by 7 plus 2 by 7. Yes, Nandana, what I have to do?
Ma'am.
Nandana Lakshmi?
Ma'am.
Can you hear me? We will add. Yes. Okay, Ann Pavida, tell me. What we have to do?
We have to add the numerator.
So what will be the answer?
6 4 by
plus 2?
7.
4 plus 2?
6. Ma'am, 6.
What will be the numerator? Denominator, same denominator. Understood? We will add the numerators together. 4 plus 2, 6. And the denominator remains the same. No change. And what about here? 9 by 12. I have to subtract 2 by 12. Okay.
7.
Yes, Michelle. Tell me. What do I have to do?
8 by 12.
9 minus 2. What is 9 minus 2?
8 by 12.
Who is that here? Let me see. 9 minus 2. Who is telling 8? I will make you in KG1. 9 minus 2. Let me see.
Seven.
Abel Burgess.
Seven.
Abel.
Seven.
Seven. And see, children, you have to look here whether we have to add. If you want to add, what we have to do? We have to plus. If the subtraction means what we have to do? 9 minus 2.
Yes.
7. Okay. 7. What will be the denominator? Is it will be 12 plus 12 or 12 minus 12?
12.
Denominator 12. We have to do. Is that clear, children? If it is plus, we will add 4 plus 2, you'll get 6. Write the same denominator. And if it is subtract, what we have to do? 9 minus 2, 7 by 12. Is that clear, children? Any doubt? Very simple, yes? Only you have to write the same denominator, but the numerators you have to add or subtract. Is that clear? I will give you two questions, you have to do alone.
Yes, ma'am.
Eight by 16 plus 2 by 16. Find out. Then question number 2. 11 by 13 minus 2 by 13. Don't say the answers louder. I will ask one by one. Don't say the answers. First one, amen. 8 plus 2.
Ma'am,
10. 10 by 16. Very good. See, children, 16, you have to write the same. Okay. Now, Ahyan, can you tell me what is 11 minus 2? 11 minus 2 by 13?
Am I am not finished. 13.
11 minus, look here, minus, subtract.
Ma'am, 9 by 13.
Ah, yes, 9. See, children, if you have done... Nine by 13. If you have done one plus, don't think that all questions will be plus. You have to look the question, read the question carefully and write the answer. 11 minus 2, you will get 9 and write the same denominator. Here 8 plus 2, 8 plus 2 when you add, you will get 10 and write the same denominator. Is that clear, children? Any doubt here? Very easy. Only you have to add the numerator or subtract the numerator. Very good. Now, children, all of you, please take your math workbook faster. It's very easy. You can do alone in your book.
My page number, ma'am.
Page number?
Ma'am, math note.
13. We have one question in 13.
Ma'am, math note.
Math workbook. Math workbook. 8.3.
Ma'am.
I'm
okay, those who finish, please. Page number 13, question number 1. Joseph, yes.
Ma'am, I know right now I am abstaining.
Okay, so I will send that. Okay, I'll send that in the Okay, my dear. I will send the notes. Okay. Now, Abel Varghese, please read question number 1. Abel Varghese, page number 13, 8.3. Question number 1. Can you read?
The fraction greater than 4 by 5 is...
Yes, fraction greater than 4 by 5. See, children, this we are doing page number 13, chapter 8.3. Chapter 8.3, question number 1. So, the question is the fraction greater than 4 by 5. 4 by 5. So, we have question number A, 1 by 5, 2 by 5, 4 by 5 or 5 by 5. Which is greater than... 4 by 5?
5 by 5.
Very good. So option?
D.
Okay. Option D is correct answer. Olivia, can you read question number 2?
Less than 4 by 10 is?
Fraction less than 4 by 10. Look at the options. Look at the options and tell me which fraction is less than
1 by 10.
Is it 1 by 10, children?
Yes.
Yes. So option?
1 by 10.
B. Option B.
Option B.
Vishnu Manoj, can you read question number 3? Vishnu.
The fraction equal to
2
by
6
is
fraction. So children, we have studied how to make equivalent fraction. We know what is equivalent fraction? Fractions that denote the same part of a whole. And how we can make equivalent fraction? Who can give me that answer? How we can make equivalent fraction? Yes, Jovidia.
1 by 3.
But I am asking how we can make equivalent fraction?
Multiply or
divide. Very good, children. Very good. You remember we can multiply or divide to make equivalent fraction. So tell me the fraction equivalent to 2 by 6?
1 by 3.
How you got? You divide by which number?
Divide.
Ah?
2.
Yes, 2 divided by 2 is 1. 6 divided by 2, the answer is 3. So we have studied this already in chapter 8.1, how to make equivalent fraction either by multiply or divide the numerator and denominator by the same number. So yes. Which is option, children? Correct? D. Option D. Okay. Next one, Devananda, can you read question number 4? Yes, Devananda. Question number 4.
The sum of 3 by 5 and 1 by 5 is?
Yes, sum means what we have to do, add or subtract.
4 by 5.
Add means you have to find the sum, means you have to add. So what is that? 3 plus 1. What's the answer?
4 by 5.
4 by 5.
Is it 4 by 5 or 4 by 10?
4 by 5.
Huh? 5. Yes, children, we will not add the denominator. Yes, write the same number, 4 by 5. So, option
C.
Correct answer for option C. Next one, Juwan, Biju, can you read question number 5? Juwan?
I know the answer.
Okay, my dear, please wait. Those who know the answer, please check whether your answer is correct or wrong. Juwan is going to read question number 5.
4 by 7.
2 by 7. 4 by 7, 2 by 7. Is there, what do you have to do?
Minus.
Minus 2. 4 minus 2. Tell me the answer.
2 by 7.
Yes, option D is correct answer. Option D. Amen. Read question number 6.
Okay, ma'am. The sum of 5 by 6.
Sum of 5 by 6 and
7 by 6.
5 by 6 and 2 by 6 means you have to add 7 by 6. Which option is correct?
Option A.
Okay. So children, how we are adding or subtracting? We will do only add or subtract which only their
numerator.
Question number 7. Navneet, can you read question number 7? Read question number 7.
Like fractions, add only the numerator.
Numerators, yes.
Numerator.
Children, you have to write, while adding like fractions, add only their numerators. Numerators. Question number 8, Michelle.
Ma'am, I already wrote.
Okay, those who have written, though already written, please check whether your answer is correct or wrong. And those who have not done, please do it fast. Yes, sir. Who is going to read now? Question number 8, Michelle.
Question number 8. The denominator of the sum of the fractions.
The denominator of the sum of the fraction 3 by 5 and 2 by 5. No need to
subtract.
Only denominator.
Equal 5 by 5.
Yes, that sum will be 5 and they are asking the denominator. You have to write 5. Okay.
Five.
Now, Olivia, can you read question number 9?
Okay, ma'am. 3 by 7 minus 2 by 7 equals
3 by 7 minus
7
by 7 equals
1 by 7.
Very good.
Ma'am, next, Jomaria.
Yes, Jomaria.
Add 2 by 3 and 1 by 3.
Okay, question number 10. We have to do
3 by 3.
Now, children, this 3 by 3, is there any idea? If the numerator and denominator means, if they are same, what is that? We have studied. Do you remember?
Yes.
The denominator are same.
Denominator and numerator same means what? The full, the whole. So it, we can say 1. Okay, if the numerator and denominator are same, that means if, for example, one pizza is divided into 3 parts, you are going to eat all the 3 parts, that means you have eaten one full pizza. Yes? So children, we can write here, this is equal to
1 by 3.
3 by 3 is 1. That is a full, the whole. Okay, question number 11. Juwan MJ is there? Juwan MJ? Can you read question number 11? I think you are facing some network issue. Okay, Juwan, Ayman, can you read? Juwan, you are facing some network issue. It's not clear. That's why. Ayman, Ayman, yes.
Okay, subtract 1 by 8 from 5 by 8.
Yeah, children, which is a bigger fraction here? 1 by 8 or
4 by 8?
Tell me, which is bigger here?
5 by 8.
5 by 8.
To start from big number, subtract 1 by 8 from 5 by 8 means after. From, that is a greater fraction. So what do you have to do? 5 by 8 minus 1 by 8. So 4 by 8. Okay. Adidev K, yes. Next one. Question number 12. Yes, Adidev, please read.
Okay.
Question number 12.
Okay, ma'am. Find the sum of 7 by 14 and 6 by 14.
7 by 14 plus 6 by 14. Add and tell me 7 plus 6. 13 by 14. So this is the answer. Question number 12.
Finished.
Savion, question number 13. So children, those who finish, please wait and check whether your answer is correct. Yes, Savion, read the next question.
I'm correct.
13.
In the given figure, find the fraction represented by the shaded parts, then find the fraction of the unshaded.
Unshaded. See children, here simply we can hear a fraction of unshaded easily from the picture, no? What is the answer? Fraction for unshaded, look at the picture.
2 by 6.
But here, children, we have to subtract. So what we have to do here, first they are asking, then find the fraction represented by shaded, then find the fraction for unshaded. So first we have to write the fraction for shaded. So we have to write the steps. Okay, so we will do it together.
Total number
13. We have to write with steps. Total number of equal parts. Total number of equal parts. Count and write.
6.
Total number of equal
parts. You have to count and write all the children. Okay. Then what do you have to do? Number of fraction for shaded parts. Fraction for shaded. Fraction for unshaded. Children, Kailasa, total number of equal parts, what's that? Total number of equal parts?
Six.
Oh, fraction for shaded. Devananda, fraction for shaded. Look at the picture and tell
four
me.
Four by six.
Now, one minute, I will share the screen now, but I want to say something. See, children, you can simply write fraction for unshaded, that is 2 by 6. But here we are going to use the subtraction. So, from the full means what?
Four.
Numerator and denominator should be the same. So, how will write the full, children? 6 by 6. What is that? Numerator and denominator, if they are same, that is 1. So you have to subtract from the full the shaded parts. Then also, like this also we can write. So what is the answer again? 2 by 6. 6 minus 4. Why we are using here? Because we have started chapter addition and subtraction. So we are using that subtraction here. So the total number minus, that is total number is 6 by 6, the full minus. How many parts are shaded? 4 by 6. So we have to subtract. You will get the answer as 2 by 6. Yes?
Ma'am, next question is same, but we have to find the shaded parts only.
What, my dear? It's not audible. It'll say louder. Okay, the next question also same. Yes, very good. We are getting more
practice. The question, ma'am?
Workbook. Yes.
Ma'am, can Eva read the question?
Yes, Eva.
14. In the given figure, find the fractions written present by the
unshaded.
I am doing it. Find the fraction of the unshaded parts using subtraction.
Subtraction. Okay, so children, like the same, we have to start question number 14. Well, how will total number of equal parts? Don't say the answer. All the children has to do alone. I will ask after some time. Total number of equal parts. Those who finish, please wait and check.
1 minute.
Huh?
1 minute, I am in the last
question. You want to see the last question?
Ma'am, I'm doing the 14th question.
Ma'am, I finish.
Okay. So here is the total number of equal parts. Fracture or unshaded. Fraction 4, unshaded. Don't say the answer now. Those who children finish, please wait. Then what I have to find out here? Fraction 4.
It is not finished.
Who's that?
Adam said he's not finished the last one.
This much time is needed, my dear. Only 3 sentences. Huh?
Fourteen question,
you have to do alone. Same, total number of equal parts. But here the question is different. So what you will write first, fraction 4 unshaded. Then you have to write the fraction 4 shaded.
Please, ma'am.
Joseph, what is the total number of equal parts? Question number 14. Count the total number of parts.
12.
Very good. 12. And fraction 4 unshaded. RLTP. 2 by 12.
I got the answer already. 12 by 12.
So children, we will write 2 by 12. So fraction 4. Okay, my dear. See children. If you sit together, it's not clear for everyone. That's why I told you to fraction 4
equal to 12 by 12 minus 2 by 12 equal to 10 by 12.
Very good. So children, you are able to do alone. Very good. 10 by 12. Children, those who have completed, please check whether you got this answer. 10 by 12.
Correct, ma'am. Correct, ma'am. Yes.
Am I not finished? 1 minute.
1 minute. By the time I'll take your attention. Okay, Kailas. Okay, so children, have you all completed here?
Yes.
Right. Children, what we have learned today, add and subtract like fractions. Okay, so to add and subtract like fractions, Vishnu, what we have to do? Vishnu?
We add numerators.
I add only their numerators. And what will be the denominator, Navneet?
The same number.
Same denominator. Denominator we will not add or subtract. So, to add and subtract the like fractions, children, we need to only look at the numerators and add the numerators, subtract the numerators. If it is the question is addition, subtraction, then write only the same denominator. Okay, children. So we will continue with the next class, the same topic. Okay, bye bye. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Bye, ma'am. Bye.